Okay, in this lesson, I want to give you some tips and tricks that you can start practicing now as a beginner so you can learn how to start changing chords quickly. You know, you're learning to play some chords, and chords are great. That's why we play guitar, right? Because we love the sound of the chords and playing songs. But there's only a few songs in the world that have one chord to it, so if all you can do is one chord, you're pretty limited. And that chord better be in the key that that song is in, or it's even more limiting. So I'm going to teach you how to change chords quickly. And I think what you'll find is it's just going to take some time, okay? You're only learning a few chords right now, but as you go on through this lesson, you'll start practicing this, and eventually you'll be playing it really good. The goal is to be able to change a chord smoothly every 1 second. Now, it's going to take you quite a while to get there. Don't get discouraged. Set yourself some parameters. You may just want to be able to play like a D chord and then play down to a C chord and a G. It's going to take you time to get there. Don't worry about that. You will eventually be able to play those quick. You'll be able to do that, no problem. So it's just a matter of practice and time. So what I want you to know is this. The key is learning the formation of each chord that I teach you. I want you to learn the formation of that chord. Have it in your mind. So then maybe you'll be sitting around watching TV. Have that guitar in your hand. Go pick it up and just practice those chords. Practice taking your hand off, putting it back on, taking it off, putting it back on. Now, when you're changing chords, that's kind of a scary thing for me to share with you, because when you're changing chords, you never want to take your hands off the guitar like that. There should never be maybe the space between your fingers and the strings, maybe the space of a credit card. I mean, it's that thin, so you can change quickly. If you have to take off, man, by the time you get over here, you're already on the third chord, right? So don't take your hands way off the fretboard. We want to keep them close to the strings. But what I'm sharing with you is, as you learn a chord, make sure that you just take it off. Some guys show you to shake your hands out a little bit. Come back and play that chord again. But take it off. Here's what I think you should do. Play your chord. Take it off the fretboard. Put it back on. Take it off, put it back on. That will get that memory of what that chord formation is for you. There's another thing that you can do that a lot of teachers will talk about. Some of them call them anchor chords or shared chords, shared finger chords. That is true. There are chords that have the same, that you use the same finger in when you play the chords. For instance, when I do a D chord, and this is a more of an advanced chord for you, and I want to do a C chord or a C9, what they call a C add 9. This finger right here, my ring finger, is on the third fret of the second string. I'm going to keep that finger there for my next chord, so it never comes off. I never take everything off. I leave that finger anchored to the fretboard, and all I do is I take these two, I put them where they're supposed to go, and then I can also do the same thing with the G chord. That finger stays right there. That's kind of that's a variation of a G chord. So it'd be. Okay, so that is true. Here's my suggestion to you. When I play chords, and I love playing chords, in Wow Factor Chords Pattern, the way I do is I think of the anchor chord, if you want, or the anchor note, if you want to call it an anchor note, I think of what the anchor note is to the chord I'm getting ready to play, so that I know where my anchor finger is going to be. You're not always going to play a chord that has a shared finger, right? So I don't want you to get in the mindset, okay, well, what's the shared finger on that from a G to a A minor? Well, there isn't one. So what I want you to do is think in your, once you learn your chords, figure out what's the bass note that's going to help me form my fingers around. Every house has a foundation. Every chord has a foundation. Think of the foundation note for that chord. For me, on a G, it's usually a bass note that helps me get in there. Like for a G, I know I'm going right here, and I know I'm going to use my middle finger to form that chord. So that's my anchor finger right there for me. I know I'm taking that ring, middle finger, I'm going to the third fret of that G string, if I'm playing a this type of a G, okay, normally a G is like this. But if I'm going to use my finger that's going to be the anchor finger for that chord, if I go to a D chord, I know my anchor finger for me that I'm putting everything around is right here. For me, it's that second fret on the third string. Now, that's not the first note that I'm playing. That's not the first note in the chord that I'm hitting. It's where my finger is going to go for the foundation of the rest of the fingers to follow. When I do the E minor, I'm taking my middle finger, and I know my middle finger is going on that second fret of that fifth string, and my following fingers, and there's only one in this case, which is a ring finger, is the second fret on that fourth string. So when I go to that, when I say, somebody says play an E minor, my first note that's going down is my middle finger on that second fret. But here's a trick that I want, or not a trick, but here's something that I want you to remember. Don't start putting your fingers down in some pattern like, okay, there's one, there's another one, you know, and there maybe, or on a G chord, okay, I've got this one, two, three. You'll never get there. All your fingers need to go down almost simultaneously if you can, but always form that bass note first if you can do it, if you've got time. And you'll get to the point that you can do it, but find your anchor chord note, and that's the finger that's going down first. Sometimes it's two notes. Like when I play that G, I'm using these two fingers. There's my bass notes right there. I'm going for those. And then these other two fingers follow in. I'm not telling you where they're going because that's not important right now. I just want you to understand the concept of those bass fingers. Every one of those chords in my mind, I know where that bass note is. Now here's something else. That's that muscle memory. I can sit here and talk to you and play chords without thinking about it because my hand is already formed to know where those chords go. So muscle memory is, that's why I'm teaching you, every time you form a chord, get that formation way etched into your mind, and that'll help you tremendously. Another thing you want to make sure you do is don't separate all your hand or your fingers all the way. Keep your fingers clustered together as close as you can whenever you're making chords. It's rare that my fingers are coming apart to do a chord because there's always that close cluster. Hey, these are your friends when you're playing chords. And what do they say? Keep your friends close, right? Well, keep your friends close. Keep your four friends close right there. Another thing I want you to make sure you do when you change chords, make sure that your wrist is not flat like this. You want that wrist down. Keep your wrist down when you're playing chords. If you'll notice, my wrist right here is always pointing down like that. Some guitar players, they want to put their wrist up, or they try and drop. Some guys will even tell you, drop your shoulder. Sometimes I drop my shoulder, but I don't do it intentionally. It happens that way when I'm playing a chord or something. But make sure that your wrist is down when you're playing those chords. Make sure that your fingers are arched. Now, we've already had that lesson, but I'm going to go over it again with you. Make sure that those fingers are arched and you've got those tips. When you're playing a chord, make sure that your finger, whatever finger that finger is playing on the note or on that string, that's the only string that you're playing, unless you're doing a double note on it, like that. I better not even go there right now. You make sure as a beginner, I want you playing one finger goes on one note. Okay? Make sure that you're using the tips of those fingers on each time that you play a chord. Wrist is down, hand is arched, you got that apple in your hand, and your thumb is maybe on the back of it, not pressing down, just gliding over that fretboard. Get a comfortable position for that thumb. One last thing, and I think this will really help you. Don't put your guitar in its case and push it under the bed or put it in a corner. Get you a guitar stand that you can leave it out, cheap little guitar stand, anything. I think you can get them at a guitar center maybe for 10, 15 bucks or something, I don't know. But find a guitar stand, keep your guitar out, because when you see it, you'll pick it up and play it. If that guitar is under the bed or in a corner or in a closet, you're going to completely forget about it, okay? So the goal is to eventually, we're going to get up there to where we're changing chords quickly and smoothly.